Shalom. First and foremost, I would like to give all praise, glory, and honor unto Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Harakakwadash. Yahawah is who the world ignorantly called God, and it is in the name of his son, Yahawashi, and who the world ignorantly called Jesus Christ, in the name of the Holy Spirit. I would also like to give a double honors unto my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. And I would like to say a sincere shalom unto the hopeful elect that are scattered throughout the four winds of the world, unto the servants, the prophets, the men that are prophesying and laboring in this truth and in this doctrine, unto you I say shalom. Practice patience and remain patient. That's something that we have to do in this truth. Those that have come into the knowledge of the truth, that is something that we have to do daily. All right, you have to practice patience in your everyday walk of life. All right, if you brothers that have kids, you know you got to be patient with your kids. You have to be patient with everything in this world. You have to be patient with these devils that we work with, these two-third niggas that we make common contact with. Everything is a test from Yahawashi, Yahawashi, that we remain patient. And when we do come into a situation, we use wisdom. All right, we use wisdom that we're learning, and we continue to learn that the Heavenly Father has opened our eyes to. Okay, but a lot of that wisdom is having patience with yourself, having patience with those around you, okay? Because patience is something that's going to be key in these last days, in this Jacob's trouble, when all these calamities begin to happen, all right? If you're just quick to make a impulsive, emotional decision, you're not practicing patience. You're not following what the scriptures say do, okay? So let me hop right into the scriptures. This is the book of Romans chapter 5, and I'm going to start at verse 3. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience. And every day, all right, any Jake that has a clue of what the hell is going on, all right, understand that we're under the curses. We're in captivity. And every day in this captivity in Babylon, or wherever you Jakes scattered throughout the four winds of the world are, that are true believers, hey, you're vexed about something. But we have to be patient. We just can't just, just lose it and go off on Esau and cuss out our manager or our supervisors or whatever. We can't lose it. All right, we have to, practice patience with everything that we're dealing with. Okay, and that's a part of it. Enduring that tribulation. This scripture says, "He that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved." So enduring is practicing that patience, and patience is to suffer, as the Apostle Gabar always brings out. All right, having patience is suffering. We're suffering here, all right, but we're suffering for a great cause. We're suffering for Yahawashi, Yahawashi. Okay, and that part of that suffering is us repenting, is us turning from our sin. Okay. So every day in this captivity, we're going through tribulation. We're whether it's heavy tribulation or small, it's some form of tribulation that we have to deal with. Okay, but that enduring that tribulation is going to build our patience. So when things really get fucked up out here, all right, when we don't got food, when we may not have shelter, we may not have the basic necessities, we're not going to lose it. We're going to remain patient, and we're going to wait and depend on the Lord in our time of trouble, in our time of tribulation. Okay, look at Yahawashi. He's a perfect example. All right, he had to deal with two-third niggas, scoffing at him, talking shit. All right, he was innocent, and he still, went up there and was the sacrificial lamb for the children of Israel. He practiced patience. He I'm pretty sure. Okay, Yahawashi wanted to put a bunch of niggas to flight, all right? But he didn't. He was cool, calm, and collect, all right? So we have to practice that same patience that Yahawashi had practiced, all right? He dealt with all kind of shit. Dealt with temptation, all right? We have to deal with temptation. We have to go through this tribulation, all right? Back to the verse. In patience, experience, and experience hope. So through the working of our patience, that's going to gain us experience. All right. So when certain situations arise in our life, all right, certain, calamities or whatever may take place, we are already prepared spiritually, mentally. All right. Because we've been through certain things that have built us up to this the times that we're going to, you know, we're living in, or certain situations that we may come upon us. All right, we were already built up for that. The rest of this world is not built up for that. This rest of this world is going to haste in a time of trouble. They're going to haste and look for a fast solution. All right, which is going to come in the form of pretty much selling out to the devil. All right, you know, taking this devil's mark, that motb. All right, that's taking that is the epitome of not having patience. All right, not waiting on the Lord. All right, because the Lord is not going to leave us just out there to hang, like leave us out there to, if we're faithful and true to him, he's going to be faithful and true to us. All right. And hope maketh, back to the verse, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of the Most High is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit, which is given unto us. So the Holy Spirit is actually what gives us patience. All right. Well, is dealing with us, that what helps us practice patience. All right, if Satan's on you, you ain't going to be patient. You're going to be impulsive. You're going to be emotional. You're going to make irrational decisions. All right, you're going to make, emotional decisions versus thinking about things. All right, contemplating and seeing what your best option is. All right, but like I said, that our everyday life, everyday experiences, the things that we go through, that All those things are building us up into that hour of temptation, until Jacob's trouble. All right. This is all the Lord is building us up right now. Those that stay faithful and true to him and call upon his name, the Lord is building us up. All right. And tribulation and having anxiety and dealing with all this bullshit in the world, that's nothing but building his elect up, his hopeful elect. All right. We got to shed a lot of, filthiness that was in us at once, okay, and part of that is dealing with tribulation, working our patience. All right, let me go to Ecclesiasticus chapter 2, and I'm pretty sure brothers know these scriptures, so it's nothing new, but you gotta do these lessons to exhort the brotherhood, to exhort the those that out there fighting. And let them know that you're not alone in this. All right. We all dealing with shit. We all have to, have our daily trials and, bullshit we got to deal with. All right. But it's all for a reason. All right. Everything that we go through is for a reason. All right. Everything that we deal with in our lives is a test. These are small tests. It's like you're taking a course and, you have a quiz. You have a midterm, like in college, you have, quizzes, midterms, tests. All right. And all these things, all these building blocks, these tests, these quizzes are building us up for that final test, that hour of temptation. All right. This is Ecclesiasticus chapter 2 and verse 2. My son, if thou come to serve the Lord, prepare thy soul for temptation. Prepare yourself for temptation. How's the Lord preparing us? Through going through shit in the world. All right. Having us open up our eyes to this knowledge and wisdom. All right, so we can use this knowledge and wisdom that through this, of the scriptures, of the laws, statutes, and commandments to in our everyday life. So, excuse me. So when we are faced with adversity, we revert back to the scripture. This truth should be our default. All right, verse 2, set thy heart aright and constantly endure and make not haste in the time of trouble. Hey, that's basically saying be patient. All right. It says, hey, set thy heart aright and constantly endure, endure, endure. We have to keep, you got to continue to endure until the end. Okay. And we know the end is right around the corner, man. It ain't a mystery no more when the end is going to come. All right. Verse 3, cleave unto him and depart not away, that thou mayest be increased at thy last end. Whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully and be patient. When thou art changed to a low estate, be patient. All right. Like I said, the Most High is going to, he's there for us. He's dealing with us. Okay. All right. That's why, I'm going to get the scripture in, was it Hebrews 13? He dealing with us as sons. All right. If he's dealing with you, you're in going through shit and dealing with chastisement. Hey, the Lord is dealing with you. Okay. Verse 5, for gold is tried in the fire and acceptable men in the furnace of adversity. The Lord is trying us. Okay, and that final trying is going to be that hour of temptation. All right, let me, I quoted a scripture in Hebrews. Let me grab it. Hebrews 13 and, is it 12? I think it's 12. Yes, this is Hebrews 12 and 6. For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth and scourge every son whom he receiveth. All right. Who the Lord loveth, he's going to chasten you. The Lord, that's like a father. All right. If your daddy didn't whoop your ass, he really didn't give a shit. He's like, oh, let the nigga do whatever you want to do. All right. He didn't have enough love for you to whoop your ass when you was young. So it would instill discipline in you in your later years when you become a man. So, you know, a lot of these niggas is raised by their mothers. So when they grow up, okay, they didn't have a man in the house to check their ass, to put their ass in their place, to whoop their ass. So when they grow up, when things don't go their way, or they're dealing with a certain situation, they react impulsive. A nigga go grab a gun. A nigga's first reaction is to fight or get violent. Okay, but that's those two thirds of our people that the Lord don't love right now. Okay. Verse 7, if ye endure chastening, the Most High dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the father chasteneth not? He's not a son. He's a bastard because the father don't chasten him. All right. But if ye be without chastisement, whereof all are partakers, then ye are bastards and not sons. All right. So the Lord is chastening you, you know, building you up. The Lord sees you as a son. Okay. The Lord sees you as a potential member of the elect, all right? But you have to take that chastening and take it as a good thing. Don't take it as, oh, man, you know, why me? You know, me in that woe is me spirit. Take it as shit, you know. Hey, the Lord is dealing with me. The Lord has put me through this, that, or whatever for a certain reason, you know. Let me not just react and think that, you know, it's all about me. No, it's deeper than me. It's about the Lord building me up. It's about the Lord. Let me look and see what I did wrong. Let me see where I fucked up and see why the Lord is, you know, putting me through this. And when you do that, you understand and you won't, you know, you repent and you won't make the same mistakes. That's what it's all about. All right. Not making the same mistakes as you made in the past. All right. Bettering yourself. All right. By really fearing the Lord. All right, this is the book of James, chapter 1, and I'm sorry, that's verse 2. My brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. The trying of our faith. All right, the Lord is trying our faith. All right, everyone's faith is going to be tried. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Okay, the Lord is going to continue to try your faith. When you put you in this situation, what are you going to do? You know, like the Lord did Job. All right. The Lord took everything from Job, his land, his family, all his riches. And the Lord tried Job. But what did Job do? Job stayed faithful until the end. Job endured. All right. We have to be Job. Elect is Job in these days. Okay. Well, we're going to be stripped of everything. All right. We're going to be slandered. All right. We still got to be patient. We ain't going to sit up here and defend ourselves against these devils, against these two third niggas, these heathens. We know the Lord got our back. We're going to wait on the Lord. Okay. We ain't going to sit up here and fight for what? All right. This is a fight we can't win. This is a carnal fight. We know we can't win against these devils. No, we're going to wait for the Lord to fight for us. All right. Let me see. I had a few more scriptures. This is the book of Psalms. Excuse me. Psalms chapter 37. And I'm going to start at verse 7. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. It said, rest in the Lord and wait patiently. How do you rest in the Lord? In this truth, getting closer to the Lord, resting in the Lord is being in this truth. Okay. That's being in the bosom of Yahawashi. That's a secret place, or that's a safe haven. Okay, in this truth, and wait patiently. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his ways. Everyone seems like they're prospering. The niggas out there that's not catching hell. Esau ain't really catching no hell right now. It may seem like they're prospering. Okay? But you rather get your ass whooped now than whooped later when everyone, you know, when and get chastened and scourged with the rest of this world. Okay? Because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. And we know that wicked man that bring the wicked devices to pass is Esau, Edom. All right? And hey, fret not yourself, man. These devils ain't, man, these devils is they low. Okay? This is back in Psalms chapter 40 in verse 1. To the chief musician, a psalm of David, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. He said, that's just this King David speaking. He waited patiently for the Lord. All right, he inclined unto me and heard my cry. The Lord hears our cries, okay? The Lord, you know, even if we don't say it in our prayers, the Lord knows what we need, and the Lord knows why we're crying out, okay? The Lord is not, how's it go, unrighteous to forget your labor of love, okay? That was that, I think that's Romans, 15th chapter, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so the Lord hears our cries, all right? But it said, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me, and he heard me. Let me look up this word, inclined. It says Psalms 40. Inclined, nata. To stretch out, extend, spread out, pitch. To be stretched out, like the Lord stretched out his hands unto us. Okay, he inclined unto us. Let me see. What it says in here? Stretch out to extend, as it says in was that Proverbs 1. I have stretched out my hand unto you. Let me see how to say. This is Proverbs 1, and no man regarded it. All right, the Lord has stretched out his hands to us, and you know, he hears us, all right? And you know, we stretching our hand back out, all right? Where does it say? Yeah, here it is. Because I have called and you refuse, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. That's 2/3, all right? That the Lord has stretched out to also, but they don't regard the prophets. They don't regard the prophecies, okay? They don't regard the scourges that come from Yahawashi, Yahawashi. All right, they just think it's bad luck, or they just think that, you know, they just coming on hard times and this shit going to get better. No, it's a message sent from the Heavenly Father to amend your ways and get right, all right, before it's too late. All right, I got a couple of more scriptures I want to grab. This is the book of Revelations, chapter 2, and I'm verse 10. I'm going to jump over to chapter 3 and verse 10. This is Revelations 2 and 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Suffer mean the patience, meaning patience, all right? They're synonymous with each other. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye shall may be tried, and have, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Hey, that's being patient, being faithful unto death. That's when that, you know, that hour of temptation comes, and you know you're under the guillotine or whatever torturing device Esau may have, and you still being patient. You're not gonna jump up and say, okay, wait. No, you just lay, hey, it is what it is, you know. And we pray and we hope that, you know, the Lord give us strength and put his spirit on us in that day, all right, that we may endure until the end, that we may, you know, withstand the wiles and all the trickery and the witchcraft of this devil until the end. All right. This is Revelations 3:3-10. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. This is going to come upon all the world. Okay? But this is because thou hast kept my word, the word of my patience. It goes back to patience, being patient. That we kept this word until the end. That we relied on this word to guide us and the word of Yahawashi Yahawashi, we relied on the Lord to guide us and bring us, you know, thus far. So we're going to continue to rely on him, you know, all the way into the end. I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. And he says, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation. Not saying that the Lord is going to prevent us, but the Lord is going to put his spirit on us to not, you know, take the MOTB, All right. That's what that means. Okay. The Lord is going to, because everyone's going to be confronted with it one way or another. Okay. It ain't like, you know, everyone's going to have to make a choice. But that remnant, that grape of the cluster, those men that, you know, that can be plucked out of the Heavenly Father's hand, you know, they elect, they're not going to take it. Okay. Those are the ones that the Lord is going to keep from the hour of temptation. All right. So I just want to, you know, hit a few points on practicing patience and remaining patient and being patient in this truth, because we're all in this, you know, the hopeful elect, we're in this fight together. And, you know, we got to continue to endure and continue to fight. All right. You know, so Lord willing, this lesson was edifying unto the elect. And I would like to give all praise, glory, and honor unto Yahawah Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Habakkuk, Wadash. Until next time, I say Shalom.